its ups and downs. Turn your pretty face into an ugly frown. Seems that when I fix one thing.
Hello, welcome to The Awakening. I'm your host, Angela Brown. Today's topic for discussion is diabetes, and my guest is Pat Dunning, who is very, very into what she does, and that's diabetes, and we're going to learn anything and everything as we possibly can in the next 30 minutes. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
We've had a rough time getting off today, haven't we? What is this, number 9, number 10 over here trying to get started? Tell my viewers a little bit about yourself.
Well, I started studying yoga when I was a graduate student at the University of Pittsburgh.
Mm-hmm.
I was interested.
That's where my dad was born.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Pittsburgh, PA.
How about that?
Mm-hmm.
I was studying my graduate studies in the doctorate area.
Mm-hmm.
And I met my Indian guru at that time. He was Professor Viswatkar. And he taught me yoga. I studied under his tutelage for several years.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of which he said, simply, you can teach. This was back in the 70s
before
really? They had the certifications. However, since then, I have, you know, several certifications, so
mm-hmm.
that's not a problem.
Mm-hmm.
I started teaching part-time, mainly, when I was a graduate student. And then as a professor at various universities, George Washington, University
mm-hmm.
of Maryland, so forth. I started teaching faculty and students part-time.
Mm-hmm.
And now that I'm retired, it's my full...
You're too young to be retired.
Thank you. It's very nice of you
well,
to say so.
No, it's true. You're too young to retire, but I'm glad. Go ahead.
Okay. So basically, that's it. And my interest, of course, in diabetes, as well as other special concerns like heart disease,
okay.
asthma, and so forth. I have developed yoga programs specifically for that purpose.
What is diabetes?
Diabetes is a condition in which there is a high level of blood sugar in the body, either because there's not enough insulin that's
mm-hmm.
prepared by the pancreas, or because the cells aren't able to absorb it in a particular way. This is a very simple diagram
mm-hmm.
on getting an idea of how that the blood sugar works.
Okay.
After you eat, your body digests your food, turns it into a type of sugar called glucose.
Okay.
In your intestines, glucose is absorbed into your bloodstream, and your body carries glucose to your cells along with a hormone made by the pancreas called insulin. The insulin helps the glucose to get into the cell. It's like a key that you can unlock the cell so that sugar can get inside, and so it can be used, obviously, for energy.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what we're talking about is a lot of times there's insufficient insulin, or in some way the cell is not working so that it absorbs the insulin.
Mm-hmm.
And then that results in the high sugar level.
So if it's not absorbed, it will be very high sugar.
Right.
How many times a day should you check your sugar?
Well, I personally haven't had a problem with this. I would say at least once a day.
Once a day.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Because my brother's wife was very overweight. And when she was diagnosed with it, of course, she told me that's what didn't cause it.
Right.
But as soon as she went on a diet and she dropped, I'd say 100 pounds, she had no more signs of diabetes.
Right. I think if you get some idea over a period of time,
mm-hmm.
you know, how the blood sugar is working, so it's a good idea to measure it when you just after you exercise, you know,
okay.
after you eat, so you get some idea when the fluctuations take place
mm-hmm.
and what is an average. You can go to a doctor's office every few months and they will provide you with that information, and then that's a feedback as to how often
mm-hmm.
you should check it. So when I said once a day, that's arbitrary depending on the person
okay.
and the situation.
So if you're exercising and you have low sugar, does that make you feel tired sometimes and even lightheaded?
Well, the causes of the results of diabetes can be that you're overtired,
mm-hmm.
you're very hungry, very thirsty,
mm-hmm.
Drowsy, you don't want to be involved in affairs, you know, you just don't have the energy to participate,
mm-hmm.
that sort of thing.
Okay.
I think I should point out that there are different types of diabetes.
Of diabetes,
okay. Right? There is type 1, and this results from the body's failure to produce insulin. And in that case, you have to have the insulin injected. And then type 2 diabetes is a much more normal in terms mm-hmm. of numbers of people. In fact, actually, I was just reading the statistics on that 90 to 95% of people are suffering from type 2 diabetes.
Type 2, so it's basically what they're putting in their mouths.
Yeah, and this type 2 is insulin resistant. It means here's where you have some problems with not either getting enough insulin, mm-hmm. but more, you know, the cells are not being open and absorbing mm-hmm. the insulin. And the last, there's a type 3, which very seldom comes up.
I've never even heard of type 3
in my
life.
I know, and that's why it doesn't even refer to as type 3. It's called gestational diabetes.
Gestational, okay, digestive.
And this is for, it's for when women who haven't had diabetes before, when they are pregnant, they have a high blood glucose level.
Yes, yes.
And they are very much at risk for getting type 2 diabetes at a later point in mm-hmm. their life.
Can it affect the baby?
I am not sure. I wouldn't want to answer that not having that kind of prenatal information and knowledge.
Okay. How does a person know they have diabetes? Just like we just said, they're thirsty?
Right.
They're tired?
Thirsty, tired, sores or bruises may not heal mm-hmm. easily, want to be left alone, you have headaches, forgetfulness.
Sounds like PMS.
Headaches, maybe tingling or numbness in the feet. So,
what about the hands?
Yeah,
the extremities.
I
hope everybody's listening to this. I really do. You'll get a lot of calls on this, I'm sure, because this is very serious. Don't you think it's serious?
Oh, yes. I mean, when you have that many people that are suffering from it, it's definitely mm-hmm. serious. And then, of course, when you consider the fact that our children now, the over incidence mm-hmm. and high percentage of children that are obese, they are very much at high risk for diabetes. Mm-hmm. And you can read and hear the statistics on how that diabetes is encroaching upon these poor children.
Right. Just like Bill, who's sitting in the audience today, he asked me, he told me that there was a time you look out, you see maybe a couple of heavy children and the rest are slender. Now when you look out, what do you see? Primarily more heavy children. And it's really ludicrous, because how are they getting the food? Are they not being watched? Somebody just lets them have what they want? It's scary. Yeah.
Well, it's not intentional. Just learned behavior that their parents have learned from their parents mm-hmm. in turn. Mm-hmm. And it's lack of knowledge and information as to how tremendous the effect of mm-hmm. Increasing the blood sugar, the sugar intake affects, mm-hmm. Increases your blood sugar in the system.
Okay. What are the causes of diabetes? I think we've covered that.
Yeah, we talked about the lack of insulin or improper absorption by the cells, mm-hmm. and basically, it's a result of the technological age. And that seems like a leap, but if you look at the technological age and the people, you're looking mm-hmm. at affluence and you're looking at chronic stress.
Oh.
So you have these factors working, and with affluence, of course, then you have people that maybe are too busy or stressed, too busy to work out, mm-hmm. not taking careful attention to what they're eating. So their eating habits are pretty bad. Mm-hmm. They're intaking all the sugar. There have been there's some information on the fact that about 100 years ago, people were eating maybe 1 kilogram of sugar a year, and now they are ingesting 1 kilogram of sugar every 2 weeks. So, that's a phenomenal.
That's a lot.
And the sugar is in everything, You have to be very careful about refined and processed mm-hmm. foods. Of course, the obvious is, in white sugar and brown sugar.
Mm-hmm. Which is better?
Well, of the two, I'd say brown, but
they
still list it as, mm-hmm. you can still have the same problem if you had just took only brown sugar.
Mm-hmm.
And the lack of exercise to help, get rid of that high mm-hmm. glucose level in your body. Biscuits and cakes and cookies, all the obvious, are there.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Well, what kind of bread is good for us to eat? I love oat bread.
Yeah, I think oat bread is good. It's supposed to lower the cholesterol, mm-hmm. and so that's a good one. If you're having carbohydrates, look at the good carbohydrates, the legumes and vegetables you can have either cooked or raw.
What about rice? I love brown rice better than white rice.
Well, I think brown rice is a little better, but you want to again watch that, you know, it's not the processed rice that you know get. There's a little diagram here on what kinds of foods and to create a meal plan for yourself. You want to keep in mind your own cultural, you know, food preferences, and ideally seeing a dietitian, because you, depending on the type of diabetes that you might have, she or he can help out with that. So let's say, for example, too, you want to also eat about the same time every day. That will keep the blood sugar from getting too low in between meals, and the blood sugar is higher an hour or two after you eat, and then it starts to fall. So that's an also in reference to, you know, when you would take your blood sugar level, you want to be aware of that it's higher after you eat.
Yes.
And balance carbohydrates like the breads, the potatoes and pasta. All those affect the blood sugar more than protein and fat. The American Diabetes Association says that between 60 to 70% should be carbs. That would be the good carbs.
60 to 70% should be carbs.
20 to 30 is the protein. And 10 to 20 is the fat. So you can see you want to really keep the fats low. Limit your alcohol, of course. Limit your salt intake.
I don't use salt when I cook.
Good idea. There's enough salt in the foods naturally.
Yes.
This alcohol can cause low blood sugar, so talk to your doctor before you drink.
And decide
if you do drink, drink light beer and so forth.
Pay attention.
Well, again, well, beer would be preferable to wine.
Beer's better?
Well, that's my understanding. I haven't done any strong research. I just remember that from something else I read about, you know, calorie content.
Okay.
You want to pay close attention to your portion sizes. This gives you some idea if you are going to go for that pasta that you absolutely have to have because of your Italian background or whatever. Then think about a tennis ball size, the meat, the deck of cards size, and cheese, thinking of a pair of dice. And the, here they have a little note, latest finding, here's yet another reason to quit smoking. Recent studies have shown that the nicotine in cigarettes can actually affect the way your body uses insulin.
Of course.
This puts smokers at a greater risk of developing diabetes. So.
Let me ask you about fruit. What's good? Do you like papaya? Is that good? Kiwis?
Yeah, fruit in general is good, but you know, there's sugar, there's natural sugar in fruit, so there are some sugars that might be, you know, some fruits that might be higher.
Cantaloupe.
Cantaloupe. I'm not sure about the
sugar. I think watermelon is very sweet. I don't like
Watermelon, though, is good because...
It's good, even though it tastes so sweet, though.
Well, it may taste sweet, but mainly the fruits are certainly better than the cakes. I mean, you know, if you're going to deprive yourself, then... You know, let the cakes go and go ahead and have the fruit instead for dessert. That would
be preferable. I prefer cantaloupe. I love cantaloupe. I can cut one open and sit down and eat the whole thing.
So can I.
You too?
Oh, yes.
It's just so good.
Well, fruit, my children have called me a fruit bat because
a fruit bat?
Yeah, I love fruit.
How old are your daughters?
Oh, the one is in her 50s and another in her 40s. Yes.
You're kidding.
Yes, so without revealing my age, you get some idea. So.
You know, I don't believe you. I don't believe you, no.
There are particular groups that have a tendency to get diabetes, and those obviously are those that are, you know, having a high sugar intake, but it's often in a category of affluent, middle class, and abnormally obese. All right, so those are the
Let me ask you this. Just because you're raised in a family, your parents are, say, overweight, but to them they're just hefty, are the children automatically going to be the same way?
No, but unfortunately...
See, I argue that thing all the time.
Yeah.